Hey guys, it is Thursday, EIA day, and I want to show you what happened with crude. There was a really good drawdown out of Cushing that had price rally overnight, and it gapped up and never came back. Here was the gap line, the blue line, and yesterday close was this white line. So a nice healthy gap that never got closed. We did come in a little bit to the weekly VWAP and then proceeded all the way up to R2 and came back and rested and sort of like holding. So it closed on the high, and when you have a big trend day and you know that you're going long and you have all your confirmation, higher time frame trend, momentum, direction guide, everything is there. Here's how you get long. You put it on a smaller time frame and you fit your volatility. So do you see how the volatility band, this was the right at the 10 o'clock open, how the bars reacted to that, you know, split second before the open. And it stayed with the volatility level. So you curve fit the bars to the volatility. So I had started out with a 3-3 and a 5-5. And the 5-5 looked okay because that's 10 ticks. That's like a pretty good staple for crude, you know, trading that 10 tick, but I saw that the bars were broken a little bit. And I'm a perfectionist, so I wanted to fit the bars. So you just keep going up one at a time and you fit the bars to the volatility. And so now I got it. So it came down, hit my volatility band and stayed in and kept going. So this is what I want to see. And when I have momentum, volatility matching the higher time frame, which is long, I just put it on direction long and get in these as close to the volatility level as possible. This is where I want to interact with the market whenever possible. Okay. So these came back, but did not test all the way down. It held. And when you got this signal here, the last one, inside the St. Ema, as I call it, that's my narrower super trend band. I run two EMAs, EMAs. I call it my Saint Ema at the super trend. Ema's my Saint Ema. That's your go signal. This right here is also a good signal, as well as this. But if you put a one tick stop here, you would have been stopped out. I like to have a close higher than the previous candle. So that's why this one is an okay trade to get in on this signal. Here's your close higher as confirmed right there. Boom, you're in. So your stop is very controlled behind the pivot. And you want one or two, in this instance, 3-1, but this is what you're looking for, and you'd like it to stay inside that St. Ema and run like they're doing here. So that's why fitting the bars is so critical to your success in doing this, because we are trading the volatility and we're looking for these specific setups that match. Once we have the higher time frame, we can break it down to a lower time frame and micromanage our entries and exits. Of course, if you got in here and just never let it go, you could have ridden it all the way up, riding the super trend. And this trade is still going, but most likely it's going to come back to this level here, the yellow band. What I like, want to show you something else. When I get prepared in the morning, and I know that I've talked about this before, sometimes you can get a bias and it messes you up. But here was that previous weekly point of control. So I just get a yellow band and extend it out. So I mark my charts where I think price is going to come up to that level. And time and time again, I mean, it works so well. The PPOC on the weekly was holding up price from getting to this close. So once it closes above it and it did not fake out, shake out, that was your green light to take this long all the way up if you wanted to take it. I had already done real well, so I was already out. So, another way to trade this is just trade the higher bars. This is a 25-cent bar, so 5 ticks on top of that, 30 ticks. That's $300 for a reversal. So that's an expensive bar. But I like to trade these when the I'd like to trade the smaller chart when the higher time frame is going in the direction I want to go. I don't like getting in on the smaller time frame when this is red. Sometimes I do if I'm at a support or resistance level, but if you notice, we went into the weekly upper VWAP level and never came out this weekly band. So anytime you're riding in this band, just stay with the trend. That's a trend trade. So we'll go over that on my webinar tomorrow. Me show you the website. If you would like to register for the webinar, send an email. Here it is. September 9th, that's Friday. Webinar on using VWAP for trade ideas. And I'll be having that webinar at 1 p.m. Chicago time. So I need to put that time period on my website, don't I? Sorry about that. So we'll have some live trading going on, not albeit not much at 1 p.m. But we can look at the crude close at 1:30. And see what else we can find for some trades. But I will be going over VWAP trades. And again, on the calendar, September 21st at 12:30, I will be giving a webinar on using my templates for auto trading with Blackbird. I had some problems with Blackbird today with the data freezing. And NinjaTrader will tend to freeze when you get a lot of volume, and the crude volume is very high than it normally is. And a lot of people were trading that EIA report, and my platform just froze up right when that EIA report came out. In fact, it was so frozen that it took me several minutes, like 5 or 6 minutes, to get back in. So, I'll have to figure that out. I've already got a SOS help me to Jeremy, seeing if that's happening to anybody else, or if that's just, EIA day, lots of volume, and chalk it up to just NinjaTrader not being able to handle those volumes. So we'll see. But definitely check back with me on those webinars and register for them, and we'll see if we can get some great trade setups with Blackbird. The key to trading success for my strategy of pullbacks is having a consistent stop loss and profit target, and letting a runner go. So a controlled system, and I'll show you how to get that all set up on the on that webinar on the September 21st. So thank you so much, and we will see you guys tomorrow. Take care.